I'm going to take a little tiny bit of food. All right? I'm going to say my word, drop it. Do you say drop?
Or I said drop it.
Drop it. Okay. Drop it. And then I'm going to place, just drop treats onto the ground. So those words will predict food on the ground. All right? Now I just want to be careful because he is... So, boop, 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 boop. My word is going to come first, drop it, and I place the food on the ground. Now, here's the important part, Christina. I'm actually touching the pieces of food. So why? For dogs that are resource guarders, right? Sometimes they don't want your hand down there, right? So those words are predicting something good. Just let them finish. Then I'm going to say, drop it. And then I'm going to drop a little bit of food. I'm just going to make sure they're small on the ground. And I just touch them. My hand down there is nothing terrible. This is repeated many times until... I say the word, drop it, and he automatically looks to the ground. And he's like, oh yeah, drop it means something flippin' fantastic is about to happen. And that's why you're winning with your game, because he likes you to throw it again. So that's awesome training. You're pairing your drop it with the idea of it being thrown again. And he's saying, oh yeah, I like that, therefore I'm willing to drop it. He's not willing to drop it yet for the higher valued resource because he's saying, I like that. Yeah. So we are showing him something really good is going to come after he hears the word drop it. So drop it, then we put the food on the ground. Notice the words come first. I count in my head to one, and then the food comes down. Now, this would go fairly quickly for him because I think he has an understanding of what that means to a degree. All right?
Like he knows if I say Nana, he knows when to look for her coming.
Yeah,
if
nice.
I say Nana, he recognizes Nana.
Good.
I'm the bird on top, and he recognizes me. Anyway, so they recognize the two of these guys.
Drop it. And again, I'm just touching the food because my hand down there. Now, every dog is different. Some dogs, I would not recommend that you actually touch it because they could guard their food. And that's why I asked you on the phone. I don't know if you remembered if I asked if he did guard his food, because I would say he would be very careful, but he's absolutely fine. I just want him to get used to his hand being down there, and I want him to learn that drop it means a good thing is going to happen. Okay? So once he has an understanding that drop it means something good is going to happen, right? And the food that you drop really should be something yummy, really, really good. Not as kibble, because he might say, no, I think my weed and my rocks or whatever it is he really, really wants are more valuable than that. Okay? So once he's able to, you're my best friend now, are you? Once he's able to drop, when I say drop it, he looks down,
right. Then
you're going to introduce... boring objects. So not the high-valued resource. We're not going to start with something he's going like, yeah, I want that. We're going to start with something really boring. So I got a couple boring things. Now, he doesn't have a true understanding of the word drop it yet because he's not automatically looking to the ground. But I'll show you. So what we're going to do is I'm going to get... I like that pouch.
Hang up.
What we're going to do is I'm going to get a really boring object, okay?
Yeah.
I'm going to put it on the floor, or I can hold it in my hand. It doesn't matter. The moment he looks at it, I'm going to say, drop it. So I'm not waiting for him to go over and take it or look at it. So as soon as he looks at it, drop it, and the food is going to go to the ground. And we're going to start with something really, really, really boring. Sorry if I'm making a few crumbs on your floor. So to get it, give it back to him, shaking his collar. Yeah. He's probably going to say, you see an increase in behavior. All right, so I have my object. Drop it. And I drop the food. Now, again, he's not having a true understanding of drop it yet, but when he does, when he hears the word drop it, he's going to turn and go for the food as opposed to the bag. Now, he hasn't had...
Say it. Give him your slipper.
Nope. See, so just think about that now, right? We want to start... We want a building block approach. We don't want to start with the things that are higher value. We want to start with boring. Something he's curious about, but he's not likely to say, oh, right? We still want him to be able to think. So, bag goes down. Drop it. And we put the food to the floor. Well, I'm trying to give him small pieces, and that's why I said I'll take that one back. And again, get your little finger in there.
I got treats here. Like, she didn't
give
me treats. What
do you get? I have a variety in here. Most of it is very healthy because I'm like you. I want when they're getting really high value or treats. That's a freeze-dried food. I can't remember the name, but that's a really nice treat. All right.
And it's funny, when he was a puppy first, he came home, he didn't need any treats.
He wouldn't eat any treats. Teaching a puppy that guards, how to drop something.